What I do is I start off with this. Today is February the 6th. Tomorrow I do have court. So that is my big thing that I have. I have court. So I forgot what time it is, but I know that I have court. So basically what I have court for is it is my last day out of the system. So I turned 21 and on February 20th. Oh my God. I cannot believe I'm 21 years old, you guys. I'm like literally an adult. Like, it's shocking me because I literally, like, you know, I'm not where I want to be in life. You know what I mean? Like, who is where they want to be in life? For real, for real. But what I want to try to say is, like, I'm proud of myself for being 21 and to, like, accomplish as much stuff as I did by myself is really, like, oh my God, you know, it's breathtaking. I can't believe, like, I'm a woman now, you know. So yeah, so I have court. So basically when you're in the system, you know, pretty much, like, if you're in the foster system, you don't really have much control. Like, for those that are in the foster system, they tell you what to do, you know what I'm trying to say, pretty much. And then it starts getting beneficial when you turn about, because when you turn 18, it was in the state of Pennsylvania, you age out. So, and that's not right, because people like us that don't have a lot of support systems, that don't have parents, it's not right because we're not ready, you know what I'm trying to say, to, like, totally be on our own. You know, that's like your mom being 18 and saying, fuck you. You know what I'm trying to say? Especially when you go through trauma in life and you've been through so much stuff, 9 in 10, those kids are going to go to the wrong side. You know what I'm trying to say? There's only a few that's going to make it. So the fact that they made it till 21 is really good. So basically, there's a lot of programs that you can have. Like, there's TLA, which they help with apartments. And there's so much money funded for people like us, for example. And I'll put my business out there. So because I am a foster, you know, it's completely off, but just, you know, off topic. But I just, you know, I like to be personal sometimes. So basically, in the state of Pennsylvania, if you're a foster child, you actually get a full ride to college. And I thought that was so amazing, because I know some people will watch that, be like, oh my God, how is that possible? Why you? And it's because of this. And I will tell you, because, for instance, and this is real facts, I don't have anybody to co-sign me. And I wouldn't want no adult to do that type of responsibility that is not my parent. You know what I'm trying to say? So 9 out of 10, we can't go to college because we don't have enough money, you know. So there's a lot of people in that are foster kids that couldn't afford college, you know. So now this is helping people that are in situations like us, because we can better ourselves. So actually, I have court, and I'm excited, honestly, because my judge been so much help over the years. Every 6 months I have to see him, and it's just been like something to me where it's like I'm actually excited that this is the last time I get to see him. Okay, so let's look at the month of January, just so I can show you guys what I'm talking about. So because I stuck to a plan on you guys, my month of January, I accomplished a lot of stuff. So I started school on the 17th. I literally started moving out of my apartment. There was a lot of transition. This process was pretty much of me just hustling, trying to get into my job the month of January. And studying for my life insurance and, you know, I'm trying to say, adjusting to my old job, to my new job. It was just very chaotic this month, but we got through it. You know, I'm trying to say, pay a microeconomics course, start work, order bed set, TV thing. It was just so much stuff we accomplished this month. So now this is the month of February. And this is what I'm showing you guys. And this is what I'm saying. I'm going to help you guys plan out your week. Hey, you guys, what is up? It's your girl Nolani. So I am going to be sharing with you guys my journey, the last day, basically my last court date. So since I was 14 years old, I had to go to court, which was mandatory. At first, it was definitely mandatory when I was younger, like, you have to go to court. And then when you turn 18, you pretty much, it's like a privilege, they say, to still be in care when you're 18 years old. So you have to be doing what you're supposed to do, but, like, you get a lot of benefits after 18, because, like, basically when you turn 21, that's when they stop it. And then in the Pennsylvania, though, they started a new law, which was pretty much you stop OCY and then you have your IO worker still till 23. So OCY is pretty much like supports you financially, and, like, gives you checks. So if, like, you're a foster child, for example, like, you know, your foster family, they get a certain amount of money. So then if you're by yourself or living by yourself, that will give you the extra push. And then there's also a lot of money that's funded to programs, you know what I'm trying to say, for us, which is beneficial. It's just like, you got to make sure you're doing, you know what I mean? You got to make sure you're doing what you're supposed to do. And another thing too, is since you are older, you have to reach out to them. Like, you're not a baby no more. So what I mean by that is, like, you have to reach out, which is like kind of like another job, to be honest, because you're like, hey, I have to do this, I have this appointment, I have this. So when I turned 18, I had a really problem with that, because like I lost out on a lot of money or a lot of opportunities, because I just was in that mind frame where I'm like, okay, I gotta toughen up and I gotta really be on my shit, you know. And then I was also preparing for this day of being 21, you know what I mean? Like, I wish I would have knew more about myself, because I would have, you know, never mind, scratch that. Because I had started my own spa business. I don't regret it, because it gave me a lot of entrepreneurship and all that other stuff. And I'm still good at doing lashes, you know what I mean? I just decided that I'm more better at, like, you know what I'm trying to say, with money and being in the financial industry, you know? So yes. And that's pretty much how it is. And today I turned 21, so it's just like, wow, like, I don't have to go to court no more. It was just like, you know, it's really like I'm getting older. But before we start this video, I really want to touch base on my situation. So I've been uploading videos. The last video that I posted, I was definitely at my house, and I was basically telling you guys that you motivate me, which you have motivated me, because I remember me just being really, really stuck. Really stuck and like really in the process of like, oh, I shouldn't do YouTube and all that stuff. And you guys really like helped me to get out that funk, you know, to keep going. And I really appreciate you guys. So basically what happened was, is like, I got into my job. I showed you guys my job. I was showing you guys like really like my struggle at the time. And then moving into here, I literally had footage of that, my job and everything. But somebody have told on me. Somebody told that pretty much I like had footage. And it was crazy because it was just one day. So like somebody in my city was really, really hating, like so bad. They were freaking hating. They were so fucking hating. Like, it's crazy. So basically what happened was, is I literally had 50 minutes of footage. Do you know how much editing that took? That took a lot of editing. So I was irritated, but I was like, whatever. So I got fired from that job or whatever. So I'm in the process of looking for another job. It's whatever. I don't care. No, I do care. It was a really good job, you guys. But it's just like, dang, like the hate is real. Like, you know what I mean? But I'm more relaxed, honestly. Like that situation that I've been through that I was showing you guys and like really like down bad, it really like humbled me. The experience really humbled me, and it like really like made me very calm, you know what I'm trying to say? Because it's like, I don't know how to explain it. Like, I'm just very calm now. I don't know how to explain it. Like, you know, it just really humbled me, for real, for real. And not only humbled me, it just like made me realize who's there and who's not, you know what I mean? And like, I just realized that my life is always like kind of like chaotic, and I never really know what's going on or what's gonna happen. It's exciting, but like, you know, I just gotta accept it for what it comes, you know? So yeah, so all that stuff that happened, that's pretty much what happened. So we're still gonna keep doing videos. We're not gonna let that stop me. You know, as far as like my work goes, you know, I got goals. I wanna do a trip to New York, because like I haven't really traveled this whole time. I mean, just like being so focused on school and everything. So I really wanna do New York. What else do I wanna do? Yeah, I have to pay for some of my college classes. So I really have to get a job, but I am really focused on my schoolwork this week, you know what I'm trying to say? And then I'm gonna dive into doing this journey all over again, you know? But at least I'm not like down bad like I was before, you know what I mean? So that was a little rant in the morning time. Good morning. And just in case you guys are like, what is she doing? So like, I took a bang, right? And I was watching what's that show where that Zendaya girl is on. That was really good. And I was watching Power, you guys. That was really good too. I gotta get ready, you guys, soon to go to class. It is 9. My class is in like 30 minutes. I just literally just put something on. I need to start waking up earlier, you guys. Like, I really do. I like wake up. Like, I have a habit. I need to break that habit of, like, not sleeping. Seriously. Like, I don't sleep. I worked night shifts for about 2 years, so it really fucked up my sleeping habit. So now, like, I don't sleep at night, and I sleep in the daytime, but I don't sleep. Like, I literally sleep 2 hours a day, and I think that's okay. That is not okay. That is not okay. But I don't know. Like, I'm just very, like, calm right now. Very, very calm. I'm just, like, very at peace in life right now. I don't know. I can't explain it, you guys. Ever since that situation, you guys, like, I went through the situation 2 months ago where I was really, like, down bad to the point, like, I went to Country Fair and asked for $15 to eat because nobody would help me. I'll be bitter about that for my whole entire life, you guys. I'm going to use that story for the rest of my life. So, if I say this in the video, like, every single time, don't mind me, bro. Do not mind me. But it really humbled me, though. It really did. And it helped me, like, see that, like, you know, I just keep going where I'm going, you know what I mean? And just have faith in yourself, you know? As long as you're doing everything that you have to do today, that's all that matters. All right, you guys, I am going to take a little nap because I didn't go to sleep. So I'm going to take a little nap. I'm going to go to class, you guys. I really need to go to class. And then I'm going to eat lunch. And then I am going to go to my other class and then get ready for court. And then I'm going to upload this video. Hey guys, it is 9:30. Gotta be in class, took a little nap. Gotta get up. I feel like that's the hardest part about college, is getting up for your classes, because sometimes you're tired. So I am studying. This is one place in the school where, like, nobody be, so, like, it's very comfortable. I like studying alone. You guys, so I am headed to my dorm to get ready. I'm a little down, you guys, just because, like, I was thinking about it while I was in class. First of all, I'm kind of mad because I'm missing class. And, like, I just don't like that reputation, you know what I mean? And, like, when I was in my biology class, I was like, whoa, I learned a lot, you know what I'm trying to say? And I missed so much getting my apartment stuff ready. And I'm just a little, like, disappointed because, like, the videos was all, like, a storyline, you know what I mean? So for them to force me to delete 50 minutes of a video, that's like deleting my life, or like us, you know what I was trying to tell you guys, and just, you know what I'm trying to say. So, like, I don't know, like, my whole thing was like trying to start it from the bottom, you know what I mean? And like, it's just annoying because now, like, I'm sure you guys are gonna support, but it's just like annoying, you know what I mean? Because I was in that time frame, I'm in this time frame now. It's just like, it's confusing for a new subscriber to be like, oh, what's going on? You know what I mean? It is what it is. I got my new key at my apartment because I had lost my key. I am so tired, but I have to get ready. At least it opens better. All right, you guys, so I am off, ready. Oh, I look cute. I can't wait till I become a life insurance agent. Uber.
They gave me 3038.
Huh?
They gave me 3038, not 3838.
Oh, wow.
So I was looking around. Anyway, you'll need your seatbelt.
Okay.
And I just need to trouble you for a signature before we go.
You guys, I am back already, you guys. I literally really couldn't show, like, what was going on because it's a courthouse. You know what I'm trying to say? But, like, all I could say is, like, I teared up a little bit because it was just, like, so much memories, you guys, of just, like, since I was little. You know what I mean? And, like, it's crazy because... Hold on. This door is so fucking hard to open. But I can't even get a picture, which is very disappointing because, like, at the end of the day, I don't have a my yearbook, like, what is it called, like, my baby book that I really wanted. I really wanted my baby book because, like, one day I'm gonna have kids, and it's like, you know, I don't have, you know, all I have is, like, pictures when I was older. Like, I'm not gonna have kids, like, you know, pictures, you know, sometimes I get a little hurt, you know what I'm trying to say, because it's like all I have is, like, me in this physical form. Like, everything else is pretty much, like, deleted. So I wanted a picture, but I didn't want to make it all awkward, you know what I mean? So it was pretty good. It really was good. It's just, you know, that had the pressure of just, like, make it through college and stuff like that, but it's very difficult. Like, even if I get a free ride or whatever, it's just difficult because of the fact of when you have a lot of broken education, it's not as simple as that, you know what I mean? You have literally no study habits, you know what I'm trying to say? Like, it's very hard, like, testing and stuff like that. But I try my best, you know what I mean? One semester at a time. So yeah, this is my vlog today of going to the courthouse, you guys. It really wasn't too much. I literally just walked through the courthouse. I couldn't really show you guys much because my phone was locked, but it's exciting. I'm 21 years old. I'm about to be 21. And I just gotta keep on going, because, like, in my shoes, I don't really have no other choice, you know what I mean? Like, if I don't keep on going, it was really no choice, you know? Like, it was no purpose of, like, doing what I did, you know? There was no purpose of, like, trying to make a difference, trying to make it better if, like, in the end, I'm stuck, you know what I mean? In the end, I became another statistic. So it's like, I have no choice to keep going. And it's like, where I want to go is very, very hard and, like, kind of, like, very impossible, you know? Like, my judge can say, my caseworker can be like, oh, graduate high school, I mean, college, it's going to be a piece of cake. It's not. It's very difficult. You know what I'm trying to say? Like, I am very smart, but just because of, like, my education gaps, like, I keep addressing and telling you guys, like, you know, like, I never had to really study. I never had to take a test. I just am really good at, like, memorizing stuff. I'm really good at, like, if you tell me, I know, you know? But I'm gonna try my best. I'm gonna try my best to do what I have to do, you know? So subscribe to my channel, you guys. Like my video. Comment on my videos. Because when you guys comment on my videos, it really, 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 really pushes me to keep going, because, like, even when I'm tired, even when I feel like, okay, why am I doing this, I literally read your guys' comments. I answer all the comments, you know what I'm trying to say? So
they was trying to get me out. Y'all don't know what I'm about. Y'all do it for the clout. The streets like, where you at? Told niggas I'm in route. I was working at the house and the school sleeping on the couch trying to figure out what my next move is. Come move with the movement. You see through the more transparent niggas who you guys think you're fooling. We billin' billin'. Pick your rain, drippin', drippin'.
We're like, I'm so hungry. Because it's like, I sacrificed so much in my life, you know what I mean? So it's like, when I want to get tired or when I want to get lazy, I just think, like, look how far I have came. Like, you know, even if I don't succeed at what I wanted to do, at least I tried with all my heart. That's all that matters. But, like, I can't live with myself if, like, I think, because you know what you've done, you know what I'm trying to say? Nobody else knows how much you worked or what you had to sacrifice or, like, what demons you are facing, you know what I'm trying to say? But I would know in my heart that I didn't try my best, and the reason why I didn't succeed is because I didn't put all the effort that I could have when I could. There's a saying that, like, I learned, right? It was this inspiration video that I had watched. It said basically, like, what was it? Oh, it was this inspiration video that basically said, you could have done you could have done what you could have done when you had the chance to do. Do you understand? You could have done what you could have done when you had the chance to do. That's deep. That's real deep. Like, some people, you know what I'm trying to say? Like, this is why I like really tell my story, because a lot of my knowledge comes from experience. You know what I mean? And this is an example. Like, there's a situation where, like, honestly, if I would have just done when I had the chance to do, then most of my life experience or my knowledge comes from experience. And we'll just tell you, because, like, I learned, another thing that I learned too is that it's not impossible to start all over, but it's harder. It's harder to start all over. You know what I'm trying to say? Then if you would have just kept pushing the lot, if you would have kept pushing when you had the chance to push, you know? That's why I try not to give up, because, like, let's just take in consideration. When I started my spa, right, I remember it was easier when I started my spa, but then when I tried to start my spa again, and when I tried it again, I didn't give up. Like, I succeeded, but it was much harder than when I originally started the first time, seriously. And it was just because, like, you know, I had to gain that trust again, you know. So say if I quit, you know, doing college or something, something may happen, you know, I may have a children or something, so it's going to be harder. It's not impossible, it's just harder, so you might as well just suffer through it right now. But it's getting late, you guys. Like, I mean, it's getting early because I didn't go to sleep, but I'm going to get back to studying. Like, subscribe to my channel, you guys.